I find it only strange now in my life. I look back and I say, how did I become an actress? What was I thinking? Yeah. What kind of life is this? I can't do anything else. I'm doing it. I've been doing it for, you know, my whole life.
Do you have regrets about it? Do you think there's something else that maybe you might have done?
I don't have regrets, but it's... I had an image of what it would be like that it never turned out to be like, and that image remains for me what I wanted. And a man told me a story when I was little, and the story stayed with me forever, and I don't remember who the man was. But he was on the train, from the milk train, like 1 a.m. train from Philadelphia to New York. And 1 a.m, you know, there's a few scattered people around the car, and he noticed at the end of the car an extremely distinguished old woman, white hair, piled high, some high collar coat, and very elegant and moneyed and very special. And she had a lap desk on her lap, and she was writing notes or paying bills or writing letters or something on the train. And he said, how could it be such a woman of this type at 1 a.m. on the train by herself from Philadelphia to New York? What does it mean? Why isn't she attended? Mm-hmm. Why should she travel at that hour? It makes no sense. And then suddenly he went, it's Ethel Barrymore. And it was. And she was in a play in Philadelphia.
Huh.
And it was Saturday night, and she had finished her play, and she was going back to New York for her day off, her day and a half off, and she was writing letters. And I thought, at that moment I knew that was the life I wanted. That was an actress to me. That still is an actress to me. That independence, that life has nothing to do with normal life, that self-containedness, that solitaire, that glamour. For me, that is glamour. That was the glamour of being an actress. That was the life.
Not being a movie star.
No. I never dreamed of that once as a child, even though that was my mother's life. No, it was being on the milk train from Philadelphia to New York at 1 a.m. on a Saturday night with one's whole life inside one's winter coat.
It's a great story.
That was it for me. You use that story, I'll kill you. You understand that?